Welcome, everybody. Today we've got Johannes Richter from Remedy Entertainment, who's going to talk about the game Control. Welcome, Johannes.
Hello. Nice to be here.
So first, let's start with a little bit about yourself. Just give us a little rundown on your career path to now.
The name is Johannes Richter. I now work at Remedy Games in Helsinki. I used to work for Animalogic and Framestore and The Mill as a VFX artist in film and commercials. And I have just transitioned about 13 months ago from film from London to games in Helsinki.
Tell us about Remedy Games as a company.
Yeah, Remedy as a company has been around for more than 20 years. Many people will probably know it from their childhood days teenage days of playing Max Payne, Max Payne 2 in the early 2000s, were a huge success. The use of bullet time in a game that is sort of mind-blowing. Historically, the company actually stems from the demo scene in Helsinki and in Finland that has been really, really big. Over the years, they have focused on narrative-driven sort of games. Alan Wake is a really known one, and then Quantum Break, which was sort of a hybrid between a TV show and a game, sort of interweaved those two things, and then not to forget about Control. Control is what it's called, a narrative-driven third-person action-adventure, meaning you basically run around and shoot a lot, or you fight sort of enemies a lot with your supernatural abilities, but you have a big storytelling narrative aspect to this, where you find out about all the strange and mysterious things that go on into the setting of the game. It's called The Oldest House. Which is sort of a government agency that investigates the mysterious, and you suddenly become the director, and now you got to sort it all out. So it marries the action and the fight against waves and waves of enemies quite well with a quirky, not usual storyline.
And so this was your first big project at Remedy as a Houdini artist. But what are some of the ways that Houdini was used in the game?
Biggest aspect of using Houdini in Control was clearly how we used it in the creation of those reactive or destructible environments. So there was a lot of procedural geometry processing going on, just breaking stuff, breaking hundreds of props and set pieces and bits our environments are made of. And then it has been used for more classical things like animation or sort of procedural animation, destruction pieces, the pre-baked sequences of things that were happening, very specific animation pieces, the ashtray maze, the moving walls, sometimes the hiss barriers, the blockers that sort of make the player not leave a certain area when you are in combat. We used it for rendering textures and decals, so we're quite bits and pieces all over the place, and with the main focus definitely on the destruction workflows. Yeah,
was there one aspect that was an extra big challenge that you had to sort of wrestle with, and that came out really well that you were proud of?
I would probably quote something that isn't actually from Control, the main game, but the first downloadable content we made, which is an add-on that came out about a month ago. It's called The Foundation, and this was where we used Houdini to create very gameplay-centric elements. So in this add-on, you gain a new ability, you can grow some kind of crystals out of the wall, and you can learn how to destroy them as well. Those very close to gameplay mechanics have a whole different life cycle within a game production, because they got to be around from the very early beginning when you start testing, is it even working as a game? Does it work as a mechanic? And then have to travel all the way down to the end of the final visual polished product. And that was sort of the first time that we went kind of this deep into this, and it was quite a lot of trust being put into that process. And the procedural nature of how we set it up in Houdini really helped, because we could have it being really crappy and sort of very simple in the beginning, and then evolve the visuals over time while maintaining the metrics that we needed to cater for the gameplay requirements.
So it sounds like Houdini was used quite extensively on Control. What's next for Houdini at Remedy? What's the future?
Well, we definitely want to have more of it. So we are looking at integrating more procedural workflows into our day-to-day. maybe even using some of PDG to automate some of our processes. Sort of we're exploring a bit how it can be facilitated most useful, because one of our problem really is also finding the right talent. So you don't only need people that are really sort of savvy in using Houdini to sort of invent those workflows and help support our other artists, but also people that want to live in beautiful Helsinki on the southern coast of Finland. But I'm quite confident that with the press that Control got and sort of our outreach that we're doing, that we will find the right people to help us in that process.
So you would suggest that if there's some Houdini talent out there that wants to live in Helsinki, they should look you up and go look at working up Remedy.
That's definitely what I'm suggesting, yes.
Great. Thanks so much for joining us today, Johannes.
Thank you for having me.
Take care.
Bye-bye.